Central side action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now let's head down to the coin toss. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Miami is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Florida's staff and their fans have heard all week long their quarterback's going to play terribly on the road. I think their staff's got them ready to prove them wrong right now.
I think this staff really has rallied this entire team around some of that negative talk. And I think they believe in their guy that he can go on the road and make the plays and lead them to a big victory. You know, sometimes when you hit some adversity like that, you see teams circle the wagons. And I really believe this week they've done a great job of doing that. Now they just have to go out and execute the plan and go out and win this game.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. He's to the 40. Wideout makes the first down catch.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
He's going to try and scramble. And he's tackled around the 41-yard line. And he has a huge gain.
Yeah, and I like the decision-making ability of this quarterback. He looks and looks. He sees nothing. He didn't get rattled. He sees some green in front of him, and he takes off. Ends up with a great run.
From the 41-yard line, it's first down. Around the 40-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and nine.
Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
It's third and 14. Ball on the 45-yard line. He lets it go.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. And he's taken down right around the 18-yard line. From their own 18-yard line, it's second down. And he just gets rid of it.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Hands it off on the delay. Nice run there as they work the outside. And he picked up almost four on that halfback delay. That makes it work in the middle. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. He really got a hold of that one. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Knocked out of bounds at the 44-yard line.
from the 44-yard line. First down. He's scrambling. They'll make the sack.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
Inside. Brought down at the 35-yard line. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. He scrambled. Runs with it, and he's got room. Slides down. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
First down.
They'll bring him down at the 17-yard line. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Throws complete. He's got room to work. Now it's first and goal as he's knocked out after a nice gain. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
After positive yardage. Gain of 6 on the play. That brings up second and goal. That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 3. They put everyone up on the line. Tackle made around the 3-yard line. No gain on the play. That makes us 30. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Strike tight end, and that's a touchdown.
So this entire group functions so well as a unit, and you saw it on that touchdown. Very good team effort.
Hits the PAT. A 9-play, 61-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. So our score, 7-0. Florida gets set to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. He's taken down at the 27. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Tackled after decent pickup. From their own 32-yard line, it's second down. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. 7-0, Gators. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. Taken down at about the 39-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. Set up, his tackle at midfield. Makes it to the 41. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Quick strike to the receiver. And they make the stop around the 17-yard line. Out here, and he's pushed out of bounds, setting up a first and goal. First down. They've got the defense on their heels now. It's first and goal. And down he goes at the one. And this play is number 8 on the drive. And the goal line defense digging in here. Now he's scrambling. The ball is loose. It's recovered, and he dives forward.
Yep, and this is why you need to know where the ball is at all times.
This is the 9th play of this drive.
Mike 12. Watch it out.
Ready. Green 9. Check. Lockstone.
Pass. Slings it. He's pushed out of bounds around the 2-yard line. This isn't much more than an extra point. Kicks away, and he got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Florida is up by 4. Makes it to the 34.
That brings up second.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. They come out in a goal line set. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. Makes it to the 44. From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. Makes it out to about the 40.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
Quickly to the tight end, and he's tackled at the 31.
That brings up second and one.
It's second down, one to go. Ball on the 31.
Four down. Check 59. Mike is 59.
Green 19.
Green.
caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not. Initially, it was called a catch, but now we're going to find out for sure if he at least had 1 foot in and possession of the ball before he went out of bounds.
After reviewing the play, the rule on the field is reversed.
So after the review, they reversed the call on the field. Florida is up four. At the 20, makes it to the 17.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
Fires that quickly, incomplete.
The receiver needed to get a step or two further into his route to have any chance of snagging that pass.
It's the ninth play of the drive. At the 15-yard line. And here's another third down. Tackle at the 7-yard line. Hit immediately. Well, I thought they'd keep it on the ground here, but they go to the air and pick up the first down.
I think the defense thought they were going to the ground as well, and that's what let this guy get open for a split second and get the first down.
Touchdown, Gators! Splits the uprights with the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. From their own 39-yard line, first down. Got a man complete, and he's hit hard. How about that play?
That's a good pickup there. He just dropped back and delivered a nice throw.
The Hurricanes taking their first time out of the half. That's a great tackle at the 38. The blitz worked on that play as they got to the quarterback.
Well, the linebacker's going to get credit here for the sack, but that was outstanding coverage downfield. The quarterback didn't have any options downfield, giving the linebacker time to make the play.
With the pass, incomplete.
It's always tough trying to put the ball out of the defender's reach, but where your guy can still come down with it in bounds. It takes a lot more precision than it looks.
Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there and one of his guys can come down with it. Going deep, lays it out there. Incomplete, almost picked off. We're halfway through, and it's been a good one. 14-3, Florida.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnovers. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson, Oakland, stud, and they got three receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here? Got a good, well, good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later.
Yeah.
We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Are they stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Three down. Mike 12.
Here's a throw, and it's almost picked.
Boy, Brad, this guy drops an interception, and what's ironic about that from going to the meetings the other day is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver. You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch the ball as a defensive back.
They work the right side, and there's nothing going there. And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Brought down at the 35. The offense is coming out on the field, and they haven't had any problem finding the end zone lately. He's on the run. So the quarterback keeps it for 2 yards.
That time, it was the sophomore corner who got in there to make the tackle.
It's second and seven. Ball on the 37. He's scrambling. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. And he's taken down at the 45.
That makes it first and 10.
He's got the corner. He's at the 40. And they push him out around the 39-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 39.
Check 59. Mike is 59.
Mike is 59.
80. Line 80. Right.
80. And he just gets rid of it.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Makes it to the 27.
Gain 12 yards.
From the 27-yard line. First down.
throws it in a hurry.
He gets hit out of bounds
around the 14-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Tries to buy some time. They bring him down.
I think this defensive end is doing a great job of getting after the quarterback, not only with the sack in this case, but it seems like the entire game he's done a good job of creating pressure, making this quarterback feel him, and almost giving him happy feet back there. He doesn't seem to be in rhythm and almost seems to be throwing the football, feeling the pressure and almost creating nerves on the quarterback.
This is the eighth play of this drive. After a decent run up the gut.
Gain of five on the play. That'll bring up third and eight.
It's third and eight. Ball on the 12.
Three down. Check 59. Mike is 59.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. Brought down at the 5. He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
Around the 4-yard line. Defense stiffens there and gives it back to their offense.
This time the offense isn't successful on fourth down. The defense had that option play snuffed out from the get-go.
They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Hand off, and he's met in the backfield. Second down. This is a scary spot deep in their own territory. They line up in the jumbo set. Again with the run. We've got a safety.
Chalk that one up to the defense making something happen. The play call was the right one, but they just blew it up and dragged him down in the end zone.
gets out to about the 38-yard line. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. He's got it with room to run, and they make the stop at about the 49. From the 49-yard line, it's first down. He has some room. He's taken down around the 38-yard line. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Tackle made at the 39-yard line. From the 39-yard line, second down. Down he goes at the 29.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it 31.
Right and left, right and left. Go down. Check 59. Mike is 59.
Big opening. And he's tackled right around the 14-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 14-yard line.
Check 59. Mike is 59.
Now he's scrambling. Going to scramble once more. He's knocked out of bounds at the 3-yard line. And this is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. The Gators with a 13-point lead. In this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Check 59. Mike is 59.
Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. That's a great tackle at the 2-yard line. From the 2-yard line, second down.
Come on, D.
And he adds the extra point. Florida gets set to kick this one away. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Across the 30. He's tackled at the 41. The last drive not only failed to produce points, but it cost them two.
The defense is going to be coming out here on the field thinking they have their opponent's number. So somebody from this offense will have to show them something to get them to respect what they can do.
Slides down. So the keeper goes for about 7 yards. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Steps out of bounds at the 49-yard line. He steps
up at the 46-yard line. Maybe 3 yards that time on the pass.
The defense respects this guy and knows they have to pay a lot of attention to him. He didn't have any room after that catch.
From the 46-yard line, it's second down. Makes the catch, and look out, out of bounds, around the 36-yard line. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
And he's taken down right around the 26-yard line. They complete the slant, good for 10. Second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker.
By 12, by 12.
Under pressure, going for it all to the end zone. This one will fall incomplete.
Hey, I know he dropped it, but the safety put himself in a position to make a play. That's impressive.
Tackled at the 22. Open receiver, no good. They tried to fool him by running the same play again.
Well, fooled no one there, Brad.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive.
Three down.
Just under three to go in regulation. Down at the 17-yard line. They'll line it up again on third down. Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense.
Was sailing out of reach, but he just climbed the ladder and made a spectacular interception.
From their own 20-yard line, first down. Straight run here, and he's got nowhere to go. They'll bring him down at the 17. From their own 17-yard line, third down. Out to his wideout. He's hit and taken down. Under a minute left in the game. Excellent punt. They'll bring him down at the 37.
They threw a pick the last time out. Should be interesting to see what they do this time.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
Tackle right around the 36-yard line. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, 23-3, Gators. Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us?
They've talked about the rivalry all week long, and for good reason. We saw the intensity down in the field every play, and it showed us why these teams love to hate each other. It'll be interesting to see how this game carries over the next time they play.
Going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.